Hello foodies, in today's video let's make a creamy and delicious kheer using mangoes and makhana, the mango makhana kheer. Let's get started. Heat a heavy bottomed kadai or wok and add 1 teaspoon of ghee to it. Add 1 cup of makhana or lotus seeds or fox nuts and roast them on a low flame till they turn crisp. Please note not to fry them on a high flame as they may turn brown quickly without becoming crunchy. Now that the makhanas are roasted, let them cool completely and then transfer them to a blender jar. You're going to pulse them a couple of times until it becomes a coarse powder. Now this is how the coarsely crushed makhanas look like. You're going to set it aside. Heat the same kadai and add 1 liter of full fat milk into it and let it come to a boil. I like to add full fat milk because it gives a creamy consistency to the kheer. If you use low fat milk, you may not get that creamy consistency. Now that the milk has come to a boil, you're going to simmer the flame and let it cook for around 3 to 4 minutes. Keep stirring the milk so that it doesn't get burnt, and you also want to scrape the cream that gets accumulated on the sides of the wok and add it back into the milk. Now it's been around 3 to 4 minutes since the milk is boiling. Add the coarsely ground makhana into the milk, followed by 1/4 cup of blanched almond slices. You can also add cashew slices if you like so. Mix it well and cook it for around 10 to 12 minutes on a low flame. Now it's been around 12 minutes and you can see that the makhana has been cooked well. Add 1/4 cup of sugar. You can adjust the amount of sugar depending upon the sweetness of your mangoes. Now add a few strands of saffron which are soaked in warm milk into the mixture. The saffron gives a beautiful hint of yellow color to your kheer. Add 1/2 teaspoon of crushed cardamom seeds or cardamom powder. Mix it well and here you can see the consistency of the kheer. You're going to switch off the flame and set it aside to cool completely. Meanwhile, chop some mangoes and add around 1 cup of chopped mango to your mixer jar and blend it into a smooth puree. It's been an hour and the kheer has cooled completely. Now is the time to add the pureed mango. Make sure to add the mango puree into the kheer only after the kheer has been cooled completely. If you add the mango puree to the hot kheer, you may end up curdling the kheer. Mix the mango puree well into the kheer and there you have the creamy and delicious mango makhana kheer ready to be served. You can serve it hot or you can serve it chilled by keeping it in the refrigerator for a few hours. Garnish with some pistachio slices and enjoy. Hope you give this delicious mango makhana kheer a try and let it know how it turned out for you in the comment sections below. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.